Now, here in this session, we shall discuss double rotation. And we know that double rotation will be of two types, LR rotation and RL rotation. We shall explain these two rotations with the proper diagrams. Now, see, let us suppose this is the initial AVL search tree after insertion of the element X. So, X is the element. So, after insertion, the tree has got a shape like this. So, I am reading this one, you see. This is the C left subtree. This is the X. Total height is H. C right subtree. So, that is H minus 1. So, before inserting X, it was actually H minus 1 plus 1. So, it has become H. AR, that is the A right subtree, H. This is my BL, B left subtree, BL with a height H. So, in this way, the tree is having the shapes, and obviously A, B, C are the nodes. Okay, now see, let us calculate the balance factors. For A, it is H plus 1 and this is 1 plus 1 plus H. So, it is H plus 2. So, H plus 2 minus H plus 1, I shall get plus 1. Here in this case, it is H plus 1 and it is H minus 1 plus 1. So, it is H plus 1, this is H. So, ultimately it is plus 1. Look at this. It is H plus 1 and it is 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus H. So, it is H plus 3 and this is H plus 1. So, H plus 1 minus H plus 3 is equal to minus 2. So, it is 2 times right heavy. 2 times means actually I am talking about minus 2. So, 2 times right heavy. And its right child is 1 time left heavy. So, it is right and this is left. So, RL. So, it is RL. You see, it is 2 times right heavy and the right child is 1 time left heavy. If such occurs, then you should go for double rotation. Double rotation means, I know it is plus 1. I know this one. It is plus 1. Here, I am not expecting any rotation, but I should give a rotation like this. It is a first one. Then the tree will take a shape like this. Please don't calculate any balance factor for this particular tree because it is the intermediate diagram. So, for the intermediate diagram, it will come automatically, but rotation number 2 will remain pending for it. So, it is the intermediate diagram. Need not to calculate the balance factors because the balance factors are not going to play any role here. So, this rotation will be applied and then I shall get this one, and there if I check the balance factors, they will get balanced. Okay, so that is the way. Let us suppose we are planning that we shall not give any double rotation here. We shall give this rotation only. So, what will happen? A will go there. Just think about the issue. A will go there, B will come down and BL will come down one level. So, but this is, what is this? What is this subtree? It is larger than B and smaller than A. So, when A will go there, so smaller than A, here B will come down, so larger than B, so ultimately it will come down here. Then what will happen? The tree which was 2 times right heavy will become 2 times left heavy. Again you give the rotation, you will get back this. And again if you ignore this one and give this rotation, it will go back to that level. So what will happen? You will just switch in between two states. So you are not going to get your tree in the height balanced mode. So that's why I know it is having balance factor not minus 2 or plus 2. It is only plus 1. But I should give a single rotation here to make this one right heavy, and then I shall make the rotation this one, then I shall get this particular diagram. So, let me show you the diagram now. So, I am applying this one. So, C will be the root here for this particular subtree. C will be the root, A will be the left child. Okay. So, this right subtree will be coming down. This left subtree will be going up. And what about this CR? That is lesser than A and greater than C. So, greater than C and lesser than A. So, CR will be coming down. Don't calculate the balance factors because intermediate diagram. So, now this rotation is pending. So, C will go up, B will come down with BL. C will go up, B will come down with BL. A will go up with AR. A will go up with AR and CR. Okay. Now, what about CL? Greater than B but lesser than C. So, lesser than C, greater than B. So, C will be coming down here. Now, calculate the balance factors. Very simple. So what is the balance factor for this? H plus 1, H plus 1, 0. H minus 1 plus 1, H. H plus 1, so that is H minus H plus 1, so minus 1. So now in this case, 1 plus 1 plus H, H plus 2. 1 plus 1 plus H, H plus 2, so it is 0. Don't take this particular H, always take the maximum height. So that's why 1 plus 1 plus H, 1 plus 1 plus H, so H plus 2 minus H plus 2, will be getting 0. So in this way, it is working. So that is my RL rotation. Now let me go for the last one, LR rotation. So see, this is the initial state. So after insertion of this particular X element, so now the shape has got this one. So now calculate the balance factors. Other heights you can directly see from the diagram. So let us calculate the balance factors. So balance factors, okay, now this one. 1 plus H, that means H plus 1. 1 plus 1 plus H, so that is H plus 2. So H plus 1 minus H plus 2 minus 1. What about this one? Just see. It is 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus H, so H plus 3. And it is 1 plus H, so H plus 1. So H plus 3 minus H plus 1 plus 2. What about this? H plus 1, 1 plus H minus 1. So H plus 1 minus H, you are getting plus 1. So this is okay. So it is requiring a rotation, that is true. But what is happening? This particular node is right heavy, sorry, don't mind. This particular node is left heavy, and the left child is 1 times right heavy. This particular node is 2 times left heavy, and this left child is 1 times right heavy. So I should go, this is my left right. So this is my left right rotation. So at first I shall rotate this one so that this side will become, this side will become right heavy, left heavy, and then I shall go for this one. So the intermediate diagram I have drawn. After rotation number 1, C will be there, A will be coming down with AL. C will be there, A will be coming down with AL. C will be there, A will be coming down with AL. C will be going up with CR. Now what about CL? Greater than A, lesser than C. So lesser than C, greater than A. So CL will be there. So now this part is okay. This particular balance rotation is pending. Don't calculate balance factor for this intermediate diagram. Now go for the last one. So this is my case. So C will be going down, B will be coming down with BR. C will be going up with A with this. So A with this, C A is there, C has gone up, B has come down with BR. So what about CR? Tell me. It is lesser than B, greater than C. It is lesser than B. So CR will be coming down. Now calculate the balance factors. You'll get whatever I wrote. So that is, you are finding that no balance factor is equal to minus 2 or plus 2. So the tree is height balanced. So in this way, after doing rotation, the tree has got height balanced. So in this way, I have discussed in the previous video, I have discussed single rotation two types. Here I have discussed double rotation of two types. Now let us solve one problem on this AVL tree, and these sort of problems are very frequent in your competitive exams, GATE exams and your semester exams. So please watch the next video, that will be in the continuation of this one. Thanks for watching.